Hey everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 5 as Venice. So, let's continue where we left off and take care of our happiness first. This is actually going to be pretty easy, because we got 3 cities we can buy monuments in, and that's 2 happiness for 380 gold. That's a very good deal. There, and we can also get a monument in Lublin. We will also finish a Colosseum in 2 turns. I can switch production to tavern in my capital, which is what I did. And finally, we can actually buy a luxury from the Mongols. It's not going to be cheap, because it's his only copy, but we can do it. I don't think he values iron or horses. We can check. No, he does not. But still, we can do this. Not whales, no. Just marble and salt. We'll just have to give him some extra money. Probably around 9 gold per turn. Might be exactly 9, actually. Let's try 7 first. Okay, 8. It's probably going to be 9. Yep, 9 gold per turn and 2 luxuries that we didn't need. And we're back at minus 8. Good. We'll get more in a few turns. But this is fine. We won't get barbarians this way. I might still take Agadaika. Also, I keep talking about Poland, but the Mongols are also going to be a big threat. Their military score is actually higher than Poland's. They are number 1 right now, and they are doing really well in tech too. And they have autocracy. So the Mongols are actually going to be a bigger threat than Poland. I can get the Mongols to declare war on Poland, and I probably should. I might even give them open borders to make it easier for them to get there. Their tourism is pretty low, so I don't really care. Anyway, let's get them to declare war on Poland. They aren't even asking for much. Yeah, I think I'll give them open borders. Just to make it easier for them to attack Poland. Sounds good. And we still want to take Agadaika. Because I want to connect my territory. And I want to completely eliminate Pocatello. Just to remove his culture and tourism pool from this game. This is actually his last city. He's down to 1 city. So as soon as we take this city, his tourism pool will be removed from the game, basically. Which will also remove the ideology pressure. That's what we want. And I want the city itself, too. It's not the greatest city of all times, but it's pretty useful. Alright. So, let's see. Well, we can keep doing damage to the city. We are about to get plastics, but I don't think I'm going to wait for that. We'll just move in with melee units. We can probably capture the city with this guy. He just needs to heal. He's down to 1 health. But I can still use him. He doesn't have to be full health. And we got a promotion. That's barrage 3. Nice. We do have open borders with Poland, so we can just go through here. And yeah, do some damage to their units. I could actually kill one of these guys. Not sure if I want to. There is a field gun inside the city. No, I probably don't want to. Let's just stay where we are. Don't do anything crazy. And caravan. So, once I'm done with Pocatello, I'll just have to focus on keeping Poland and the Mongols busy. I can't afford to get attacked by both at the same time. So, I'll just have to shuffle wards around and keep bribing them. That's pretty much the plan. It's very likely that we'll end up at war sooner or later anyway, but I'll try to delay that moment as much as possible. Right, I think that's all we can do on this turn. Yep, no unit is in city bombardment, that's good. And oh yeah, minus 12. That's not so great. I guess we'll deal with that. I mean, we will get a Colosseum on the next turn. I can still buy some happiness buildings. We'll get a tavern in 5 turns. There's no need to waste more gold. This is fine. Unless we can buy a luxury from someone. I don't think we can. Not really. But we can sell a few things to Carthage. I think they will pay 7 gold per turn, no? 5 gold per turn? Really? Okay, never mind. Not selling that then. And Poland is already fighting the Mongols. That's good. I need them to keep fighting each other. As long as possible. Alright, I will take Agadaika, which will make us lose more happiness. However, As I said, it will also remove Pocatello's tourism poll from the game. Which should make us lose some public opinion pressure. Which will increase our happiness. Anyway, we actually need more improvements near Venice. Might as well get some. Is America still at war? No. Let's see if we can get America to fight someone. That would be useful. What about Poland? Oh no, he has a peace treaty with Poland. And what about the Mongols? Yeah, he would declare war on the Mongols. I think we'll go for it. Yeah, we want to keep everyone busy. And it's only 6 gold per turn. That was a very good deal. Now, we might want to kill some of these units. It's not like Pocatello can replace these units fast enough. He's down to one city, it's a pretty crappy city. So, yeah. And there's no need to rush. He's not at war with anyone anymore, other than me. We might as well take our time. That's what we're going to do. Yes, I do want your cotton, thanks. The only thing that kind of sucks right now is the production penalty from unhappiness. But oh well. The Colosseum is done. We are still at minus 12. Is that city actually big enough? Yeah, the city is not big enough to benefit from the Colosseum. I could send some food there with a caravan. But it's not going to grow when we're below minus 10, obviously. Yeah, this is a lot of units, and we did get some barbarians spawning. That's fine. We'll deal with that. I can probably kill one of them right now, maybe not. But that's fine, they can't really do a whole lot. We can attack them with one of these guys. There. Alright, let's keep doing damage then. I might as well kill these generals. Engineers. I'm hoping they will start a manufactory or something. And then I will just use it myself. By capturing the city. But they probably won't. Anyway, let's do some damage to the city. And I'll move the artillery closer to Mosunkani, I think. Yeah, just to do some damage to these barbarians. And what's next? We are pretty much waiting for railroad at this point. Alright, let's move closer and do some more damage. And that's that. Accuracy 1. One more attack. Done. Oh yeah, what was the World Congress vote? Embassy? Yeah, sure. He denounced us, so we lost the embassy. Did America get embargoed? No, they did not. That's fine. Oh, America wants to ban crab. And Poland wants to embargo Carthage. It's not like Carthage is relevant in this game anymore. So that's a pretty useless proposal. But hey, whatever floats his boat. So kill this guy. Really? You're not dead yet? Well, thanks for the experience. And we got another great general. Alright. Let's keep doing damage. Pocatello is not at war with anyone else, so no one is going to capture this city. And one more attack. I think the city will be ours on the next turn. Which means we should probably move in. Alright, let's just move in. Like so. And with the other guy, might as well do that. And go repair that citadel. Anything else we need around here? A trading post on a desert tile, that's not super useful. Yeah, we are just waiting for railroads at this point. That's pretty much it. We can actually get a few more farms around Venice. We are about to finish plastics. I will probably just buy a research lab in my capital instantly. Because we need that ASAP. No, I'm not interested. Guess why? We might not be able to take Agadaika on this turn, actually. Also, look at the mercenaries. There are no mercenary contracts available. The AI hired all the available mercenaries. Every single one. So yeah, I really like the mod, but it could use some balancing on deity. I don't think I'll be using it in the next game, but that's mostly because of the crashes. I'm 99% sure that the crashes earlier were related to the mercenaries mod, which is unfortunate. Right, back to Agadaika. Not sure if we can take it on this turn. We might be able to. Actually, yeah, I think we can. So this will make us lose more happiness temporarily. But it will remove Pocatello's tourism pull from the game. So yep, take the city. And he's eliminated. Bye. We took some great works, nice. There, we will be at minus 15. For a little bit. Anything useful in this city? Yeah, quite a few useful buildings. A public school. This is a pretty nice city. Colosseum, pagoda, a manor. How many more turns for Mosonkani? 14 more turns. That's a lot of turns. Alright, research. I think we need railroad at this point. Yes, we do. And then biology? Yeah, we need so many cheap techs still. What are our scientists, spies doing? Yeah, I think it's actually better to research a few of these cheap techs. Because I might be able to steal something useful here. I might not be able to steal railroad. I don't think any of these guys have railroad yet. At least it's not quite obvious. So it's better to research these cheap techs before our spies do their job. Yep, that's what we're going to do. We got 8 turns. So... yeah, we can research these two and then maybe steal archaeology. I wouldn't mind some culture. Repair this and we should connect Mosonkani to our trade network. That's for sure. We'll work on that. We might get one more round of barbarians spawning somewhere around here, which would be pretty annoying because I don't really have a lot of units anywhere close to my core cities. Also, research lab, let's just buy that right away. It's not cheap, but whatever, we are buying it anyway. And lock the specialist slot. Maybe redo this. Keep it on production. And we'll keep working on Summer Palace. But one wonder I really want is Big Ben. That's such a good wonder for Venice. I don't think we'll have a lot of competition for it because it requires commerce. Does anyone actually have commerce? Doesn't look like it. So, yeah, I think we can build it without any problems. Look at all these policies Poland has. Yeah. Poland isn't overpowered at all. Not even one bit. I don't know what you're talking about. Yep, that's Poland for you. They are insane. So what about that scientist? I could pop the scientist now to steal something more expensive. But we won't be able to steal biology because we would have to get both of these techs. That's clearly not going to happen. Yeah, we'll save the scientist for later. As for Agadaika, oh yeah. Wait, what? I don't want to raise the city. Yeah, stop city raising. There. And we're back in positive happiness. Good. So, what's next? First, let's use the promotion. Shock 2 and upgrade our Great War Infantry to proper infantry. Oh wow, America already has rocket artillery, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. That means they will have an easier time fighting Poland. Or the Mongols. Can we get them to declare war on Poland now? Probably not, no, he still has a peace treaty. So yeah, the next step is to keep the AIs busy. And you know, focus on actually getting some techs. Any more upgrades? No, that's it. I'm a little bit worried that America will start working on the Apollo program soon. If they manage to build the Hubble Space Telescope, this will be pretty hard to win. They will probably win with a spaceship if they manage to build the Hubble Space Telescope. So I think we have to rush to rocketry and satellites. How many techs does he actually have? He has 67 techs. Not that many, 6 techs ahead of us. He doesn't have rationalism, does he? Oh yeah, he actually does, right. He will probably try to build Hubble, and he might succeed, unfortunately. Still, I kind of want archaeology. I'm hoping I'll be able to steal railroad from Poland. We got 7 more turns. Well, we'll see. Finish research and then we can get navigation or something. I mean, we'll need biology because we need oil. Okay, this is fine. And we're done here from the looks of it. I might have to go to war with America myself later. But it will be pretty damn tough. I would basically have to build a pretty significant navy, which would take a while. Especially with only one city that I can directly control. We could always buy some ships, but that's not exactly cheap. That's not cheap at all. Alright, well, you guys are just going to wait until we get railroad, which hopefully won't take too long. I will keep most of my units here. You know, because if we get attacked, we'll get attacked here. That's pretty obvious. I do have quite a few generals, so we could also get several citadels in this area. We would likely need citadels both to the north and to the south to protect ourselves from both Poland and the Mongols. The part that really sucks about America is that they have their own continent, so I can't really count on the AIs to hurt them in any significant way. Which is really unfortunate. That's the worst part about this situation. If they weren't on their own separate continent, this would be easier. But they are. Anyway, let's spread out these generals. One can go to Carthage, and we'll keep one somewhere around here. Alright, sounds good. And we have a lot of tiles to repair. Are you done? No. Okay, oh yeah, we have one more worker in here. We just have to move through. Next, you can build a farm. 9 turns for a great engineer. I'll have to save him for Hubble. It's pretty unlikely that we'll be able to get Hubble, but we can still try. I mean, I will obviously try. We'll get a research agreement triggering in 6 turns. Unfortunately, America will also get science from that. But I got the Porcelain Tower and Scientific Revolution, which means I'll get much more. Another trade route. That's going to be probably Bezhbalik. That's 20 gold per turn. Looks pretty good to me. And cargo ship, I'll just go for the best trade routes at this point. And that's that. There's actually an antiquity site over here, which we can see despite not having archaeology. Probably because someone started excavating it and then stopped. And yeah, our luxury got banned. Oh well, whatever. Our happiness is still okay. Minus one is good enough. As for you guys, any luxuries we can repair? Not really, just a lot of tiles. But I should start building a road to Mosonkai. Agraika is connected, right? Oh yeah, one road section is pillaged. Yep, repair that then. How many more turns for that spy? 4 more turns. Well, hopefully we'll get something. It's possible that our spy will get killed, which would be unfortunate, but it's a possibility. Right, I can't really research archaeology unless I just pop that scientist. It wouldn't help though, because again, I can't get biology without armor plating. Oh yeah, truffles from the Mongols. I kind of need that. He actually accepted, nice. So 6 turns for a research agreement. And 4 turns for the spy to steal something. We'll get some nice progress. As long as we can actually succeed in stealing something. So I don't plan any new wars in predictable future. That would be a rather poor idea. We could sell some coal. Might as well, yeah. At least some of it. You can never have too much gold. Hopefully Poland will keep fighting the Mongols for a while. I need them to do that, I really do. 9 more turns for Mosonkani to get out of resistance. Mosonkani will give us a really nice boost. It sucks that I can't control cities directly. I would easily be over 1000 science per turn if I could control my cities directly right now. But that's Venice for you. Right, well, repaired some stuff here. This should probably be a mine. Let's take care of that road to Mosonkani first. Yep. But we'll have to redo this a little bit. These roads are not exactly optimal, to say the least. Yeah, remove these two. They are not necessary at all. Yep, remove the road. And that's that. Mosonkani is actually on research, that's interesting. Well, it's not producing anything right now because it's in resistance. There's navigation. And right, we can choose a great person because we finished the Summer Palace. I need both scientists and engineers. But one thing I can do is use faith to buy an engineer and then get another engineer. Now we don't have enough. And I can't faith buy a scientist yet. I'm not sure if I'll have the time to finish rationalism. Probably a little bit later. But I want at least one level 2 tenet in order. Because the level 2 tenets in order are just so good. I think we'll go for a scientist. That makes sense. Okay, let's go for a scientist. I mean, I'll need a lot of science. I could technically go for Merchant of Venice, but that would be a little bit silly. Now, let's not do that. It will delay the Great Engineer slightly, but that's okay. I don't really need him right now. No, I don't. As for you guys, well, you're just going to wait for Railroad. As for research, we got one more turn. Let's just start researching warships. Because I have no idea which tech I'll be able to steal from Poland. I don't know if they have railroad. I don't actually see any railroads in their territory. So we'll find out. As for production, what do we need in here? I should probably build Artist Guild. Although I might not be able to work it without sending more food to Venice. But we kind of need it. It's not like I can work it in any other city. I can't. Alright, we'll do that. It's only 3 turns. I'm hoping Poland and the Mongols will lose a lot of units from this war. And oh, we can steal electronics. Nice. Well, that's obviously what I'll get. Because that's worth 8,000 science right now. Double the cost of archaeology. Poland probably won't like it, but I don't care. I need techs. I will have to steal techs. I don't actually have a choice. How many turns do we need now? 94 turns. That's a little bit too much. And 247 turns in Turfan. Yeah, that's way too much, unfortunately. We could try a different city. We could try to spy on America. I might try doing that, yeah. But not on their capital, preferably. Alright, we'll try. We'll see how many turns it's going to take. Probably a lot, but less than 200. Maybe. As for our research now, we should probably swap it now. We can get a railroad now. I just need to go for rocketry. I might have to skip these tags, although I really want archaeology. We need more culture to get more tenets in order and to also finish rationalism. I kind of have to finish rationalism, but I also need at least one level 3 tenet in order. Yeah, I'm going to need at least one tenet in order, one level 3 tenet. And Washington finished the Apollo program. That's a lot of antiquity sites. Oh yeah, that was the research agreement that popped, right. Holy crap, this is a lot of antiquity sites. The only downside is that I won't be able to log them manually. I'll have to count on cities working them on their own. But we got 3 antiquity sites in range of Venice. Another downside is that, you know, we actually have to build archaeologists ourselves. We can't buy them. Which means I have to do it in Venice. I'll get these 2 for sure. And then we'll see. Yep, sounds good to me. And we need a new research agreement with America, unfortunately. It's quite likely that America will win this for a spaceship. But I'll try to stop them. We are only 3 techs behind. We'll see how it goes. if I optimize my scientists and if I manage to get Hubble before they build it, this should be doable. We will get another engineer in 12 turns, so that guy will be used to rush Hubble. We just need to get to satellites ASAP. So yep, that's what we're going to do. I might pop these scientists once we get closer, but we'll wait 12 turns. We need to wait for the engineer anyway. There is a chance that we'll get Hubble. We'll see. Let's vote for America, maybe. Or maybe not. How are our relations with Poland? Yeah, not very good. We'll probably end up at war with Poland. Let's just vote on America. Yeah, vote on America. And repair. We got a caravan. I might send some food to Venice. But a cargo ship would be way better for that. Yep, it would be. Okay then. Poland. They are still at war with the Mongols. Hopefully it will stay that way. As long as possible. Would be nice to get America to declare war on Poland.
Good day.
Would they actually do it? Yeah, they would. I might go for it, but it would be best to get America to declare war on Poland on the same turn they peace out with the Mongols. Because then we can try to keep them at war constantly. Hopefully America would stay at war with Poland for at least 15 turns, and then I would get the Mongols to declare war again, or at least try. The Mongols might attack me, but they are also at war with America right now. As I said before, the plan is to keep the AIs at war with each other as much as possible. Oh, come on, Poland, that's my side. Okay, that's pretty annoying. I'm gonna have to protect my sides. Let's just do it like this. With the scientists, because why not? And where are all our sides? We can still cycle through them. There's one over here. So we need a unit over there. There's one over here. I'll just grab the workers, although we are about to finish the railroad. Yeah, I don't want them to have the open borders with us anymore. Okay, whatever. I don't think I'll be recruiting that many archaeologists, because we just don't have the time for that. We'll get the two next to Venice. And maybe one or two close to our biggest cities. And on actual good terrain. But that's it. I don't think I'll be getting every single one. Farm. Okay, one more turn for railroad. And we got a policy. I think we need a tenet. So, either 5-year plan or workers' faculties for the science boost. We could also go for happiness, but I need the science boost. I really do. Yeah, oh yeah, I can't cycle through cities as Venice. That's so annoying. Yeah, I can't easily check how many cities we got factories in. I can always just buy factories for gold in my top science cities. We don't have a lot of cities with good science other than our capital for obvious reasons, because we can't control the specialists. Yeah, I would be so much further ahead right now as any other civ. I think we'll go for workers' faculties though. I could also just finish rationalism right now. Or not literally right now, but focus on finishing rationalism. I would like to get free thought and the rationalism finisher. I think going for rationalism first is a little bit better in this situation. Yeah, because we'll get a rationalism finisher in 19 turns. So, between our two scientists, the rationalism finisher, and 822 science per turn, we should be able to get satellites in 19 turns. I'm pretty sure that's going to be enough. We can get, yeah, almost 18,000 science from these two guys. I'm pretty sure that's going to be enough. Alright then, but I'm going to finish this part here and continue in next one. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.